using the same data, consider this problem. Which city had the largest percentage decrease in number of offenders? You don't need to worry about what do you mean by offender, defender. Between 99 and 2006. Try this problem. Okay, if you want to consider the decrease, here to here it is an increase. So, C cannot be that city. Here to here also you see an increase. So, B also cannot be the answer. There is a decrease in city A as well in city B. So, what is the decrease? Decrease is 16 upon 396. That is in city A. Whereas decrease is 10 upon 176. That is in city D. So decrease with respect to what? With respect to original. Original value is 396, 176. That is why I have taken the original values. Right? So if you compare these two, you want to look at the largest percent. So which is a better ratio? Whether this is a better ratio or this is a better ratio. Right? 176, if you double that, how much you get? So let us say 175. 175 double of that is 350. Double. So if this also is double, that is if this is 20, then both are same. Right? Right? So what I am considering is the increase. From 10 by 176 to 16 by 1, 396. This is more than double, whereas this is less than double. So what do you understand? This ratio is less than this. So the answer is city D. Otherwise, you can find the answer through calculator. Let us take next data. The graph below shows the sales and consumption. Figures of shoes from February to July. Sales and consumption of shoes. This is factory output. Factory B output. Total men's shoe sold. Total women's shoe sold. February and factory output. Factory B output. This is the data given. With this data, let us consider few problems. What was the excess production of shoes in April that were not sold? Try this problem. Okay. Answer should be very easy. In April is what you're talking about. So April data, if you look at, what is the difference between these two? By the way, this is sold, this is produced, right? So sold versus produced is 1000 less, right? These many were sold, these many were produced. I'm just talking about the difference here. Also, if you look at this difference, this is produced, this is consumed. So difference between these two, now this one gap is 1000, difference between these two is 1500. So 1500 minus 1000, so 500 shoes were left unsold. That's the answer. You don't need to take this value as produced from A, 5000. This will be a lengthy method, this is a shortcut. 5000 plus produced output of this 1500 minus consumption 3500, consumption here is 2500. You'll get the same answer. Let us take next question. In which month was total production from both factories combined the lowest? Try this problem. Rather than finding out the value separately, let us compare which month it is combined lowest production. This is a production from A, whereas this is production from B. So here if you compare that with this next month, it is value of A. A has increased, B has reduced, so they are almost same. Here it is reduced, right? Value of B has reduced. Here value of it is same. Here value of A has reduced. Value of A has reduced, right? Here increased. So in this case it is lowest. I'm just talking about the comparison. I'll repeat. If you compare these two values, value increased, value reduced, balanced by the same value amount 500. Here B reduced, A has remained same, so this value is lesser. Same value, much lesser in March. When you compare that value here in Feb, the value of B increased. So March is the least. Don't spend time in converting those values to these figures to values. You will be unnecessarily wasting a lot of time. Even if you do with that method, what I am talking about is, let us say in Feb, Feb it is 4500 plus 2000. In March it is 4500 plus 1500. In April it is 5000 plus 2000. Next it is 5000 plus 2000. Next 5000 plus, here it was same 1500, 2000, next it is 4500 plus 2500, right? So least value is this. This is in March. Let us take next question. The shoes that are produced but not sold each month are stored for when sales exceed production from the period February to July, what was the net number of shoes stored? Try this problem. This question should be easy. Going by the previous logic, when you want to consider the nets, this minus this, 500, this is same. So in Feb, stored was 500. In March, this minus this, 1000. And this minus this, minus 1500. So minus 500. In April, this minus this, 1500. This minus this, minus 1000. Plus 500. In May, these two got cancelled out. But then they are triangle and star. Okay. So this minus this is 2000. This minus this is 1500. So once again 500. Next, in June, this minus this is minus 1000. This minus this is 1500. So once again 500. Next, this minus this is minus 500. This minus this is 500. So this is the net. This is are the number of shoes stored. Let us take one more variety. The pie chart below show the distribution of energy consumption in office ABC for the years 2001 and 2009. Answer questions based on the information. PC room 12%, print room 15%, kitchen 20%. Meeting room 41%. Total distribution of energy, this is in 2001, 1700 kilowatt hour, same data in 2009. Total distribution of energy, This is 17,000. This is 15,000. Percent PC room. Twelve percent print room. 39% office room. 14% kitchen. 14% meeting room. With this data, let us consider some questions. Between 2001 and 2009, what was the increase in energy use? For the PC room, meeting room and office space combined, you take choices. 50 kilowatt hour, 184 kilowatt hour, 188 kilowatt hour. Can't say. Try this problem. Okay. Increase in energy use. By the way, in 2001, what was the consumption for PC? Okay. 12%. For meeting room, 12%. For office space, 41%. Percent of 17,000, right? Total energy was 17,000. Whereas in 2009, same. PC room, 21%. Meeting room, 14%. And office space, 39%. Of 15,000. Total is 15,000. You want to know how much is the increase, right? So if you club this 12 plus 12, 24, 24 plus 41, 65, 65% of 17,000. Whereas here, 21 plus 14, 35, 35 plus 39, 74, 74% of 15,000. So definitely it is more. So can't say is not the answer, right? Okay, 65% here, 74%. If you have calculated, it is very easy to do. Now, I do not have the calculator. That's what the assumption I am going with. Then, or this method will also help you to cross-check, right? So, what we can do is this value is more than that. And this percentage is less than this. So, what we can do is we can split this. What I am trying to do is 65% of 15,000 plus 65% of 2,000. Is what I am splitting. Now this, I am splitting this as 65 plus. Here I have split it as 15,000 plus 2,000. Right? Whereas this 15,000 is as such. The 74 I would like to split it as 65% plus 9%. So 65% of 15,000 plus 9% of 15,000. This I can do. So if you observe carefully, 65% of 15,000, 65% of 15,000, these two get cancelled out. So what is 9% of 15,000? 10% of 15,000 is 1500. 1% is 150. So 1500 minus 150, 1350. Coming to this, 65% of 2000, right? 65%, that is 65 by 100 into 2000, right? 65 into 2, 130, 130 into 10, 1300. So consumption, it was 1300, difference, I am just talking about difference, 1350 minus 1300, 8 is the answer. Let us take a short break, after that we will be continuing.